All right. Hi, this is Catherine Catalano with the Union of Concerned Scientists. I'm here in San Francisco, home to the headquarters of Uber and Lyft, and I'm here to talk to folks about electric vehicles and shared rides and how those can help reduce global warming emissions. Let's go. We're talking about ride-hailing companies like Uber and Lyft today. How often would you say you use those services?
Maybe once or twice a week.
1 to 2 times a week.
Maybe 2 times a month.
So do you ever choose a shared ride or usually solo rides?
Try to go for a shared ride.
Unfortunately, they're mainly solo.
Our driver is almost here. Oh no, she is here. We're looking for a Corolla. Emily's in a Corolla. Is that her? So if you had to guess percentage-wise how a standard ride in an Uber or Lyft compares to a personal car trip in terms of emissions, what would your guess be?
About 40% of a private ride.
About 40% cleaner or 40% more emitting?
Cleaner.
Gotcha. You were right on with the number, but actually a standard Uber or Lyft trip is 40% more emitting.
Oh, okay.
How much do you think those emissions could be reduced by choosing a shared ride over a solo ride?
Oh, I don't know. I'm not sure on that.
I don't know. If I had to guess another percentage,
20%?
Very close. It's about 30%. Is that surprising to you?
Yes, that's very surprising.
Makes me want to do more shared rides now.
Now we can get kind of ambitious here. If that shared ride was also in an electric vehicle, how much emissions do you think would be saved in that case?
In this case, 60%.
Very close, 70 actually. It's even better if it's shared and it's electric. It's about 70% cleaner than a solo Uber or Lyft ride.
Hey, okay, that's great.
That is incredible.
And what would you say to the companies, to Uber and Lyft, knowing all of this and knowing that like they have this information, what do you think they should do?
Provide your drivers with electric vehicles or hybrid vehicles.
They could create sort of a policy to influence drivers to get electric cars.
I think that times are changing and consumers nowadays are a lot more thoughtful about where they're putting their money to and the choices that they're making as consumers. So I think having that kind of eco-friendly option, I don't think there's anything negative that could come of that. I think only positive things will happen.